Okay, next point of cancer, that is the types of cancer. Benign tumor, pre-malignant tumor, malignant tumor, these are the types of tumors. Whether depending on whether they are harming our body or no. But the cancers, the tumors, where they are appearing, where they are affecting, depending on that we are differentiating these cancers into four types. That means here we are taking the example of tissues to which there is occurrence of cancer. Clear? Now, first type of the cancer we are calling it as carcinomas. First type of the cancers we are calling it as carcinomas. So these carcinomas, these are the cancers of epithelial tissue. These are the cancers of epithelial tissue. You know about the types of animal tissues. So depending on which tissue is getting the cancer, we are differentiating these cancers into different types. So first one, it is nothing but carcinomas. So this carcinomas, it is nothing but the cancer of epithelial tissue. It is the cancer of epithelial tissue. Where it is present? If we take the example of skin, it is called a skin cancer, but it is the epithelial tissue. If we take the example of lung cancer, alveoli wall, it is made up of epithelium. So it is also epithelial cancer, that is carcinoma. If we take the ducts, they are also made up of epithelium. So in which region, which tissue is affected, depending on that we are calling it as cancer. So if it is occurring to the epithelial tissue, we are calling it as carcinomas. Clear? Now, second, sarcomas. Sarcomas, it is the cancer of connective tissue. It is the cancer of connective tissue. So if we take the example of blood is the connective tissue. Cartilage, it is a connective tissue. If we take the example of bone cancer, it is a sarcoma. Why? Means it is a connective tissue. Adipose tissue. All these are the connective tissues. So depending on the presence of which type of tissue it is affected, they are differentiated. So cancer of connective tissue, it is called as sarcomas. Next, inconnective tissue. Special type and the famous type of the cancer, it is nothing but blood cancer. That's what special name it is given. That is leukemias, leukocytes, cancer of leukocyte. Leukocyte means what? WBC. Leukocytes, other name, it is nothing but WBC. That's why it is called as leukemias. That is cancer of bone marrow. Why it is called as cancer of bone marrow? Because WBCs or blood cells, they are formed in bone. Bone marrow, it is the region from where synthesis of all blood cells occur. If cancer occurs in bone marrow, it is responsible for producing more and more number of WBCs. But these WBCs, they are immature WBCs. As there is presence of immature WBCs, they are non-functional. Mature WBCs, they are showing their functional role. Immature, they never show the functional role. That's why these leukemia, it is called as cancer of bone marrow, or this leukemia, it is nothing but blood cancer. And last type, it is nothing but lymphomas. Lymphomas, that is the cancer of lymphoid tissue. Cancer of lymphoid tissue. So we have studied about lymphoid organs. So primary lymphoid organs, secondary lymphoid organs. If Peyer's patches is there, cancer occurs in Peyer's patches, cancer occurs in tonsils, cancer if it is occurring in mark, cancer if it is occurring in thymus, all these are the lymphoid tissues and organs. If there is occurrence of the cancer in lymphoid tissues, then it is called as lymphomas. So, carcinoma, sarcomas, leukemia and lymphoma, these are the different types of cancers depending on which type of tissue it is affected. Now, how we can go for detection and diagnosis of cancer? Detection and diagnosis of cancer. If it is the cancer which is occurring outside our body, that is on the skin, on the head, on the nose, on the mouth, like this, we can easily identify whether it is cancer or no. But the cancer which is occurring inside, how we are detecting, how we are going for diagnosis? Number of methods are there. So first method, it is nothing but biopsy method. Biopsy, it is the simplest method for diagnosis and detection of the cancer. What is it? Wherever there is a formation of cancer, cut that cancer, observe under microscope. Cut small portion of that cancer region, that is we are getting the tissue, that tissue it is observed under the microscope. If change in structure of cell occurs, it is nothing but detection of the cancer. Or cutting, observing under the microscope, using different stains to identify the cancer, all this it is nothing but histopathological study. So cutting and observing the tissue of the cancerous cell under the microscope, it is called as the biopsy method. And when we are going for staining, identification of the cancers with the help of staining or other chemical methods, then it is called as the histopathological study. For leukemia, detection and diagnosis, it is occurring by blood test. If we are going for blood test, how much WBC count should be there? If it increases, then we are going for observing the structure of the cancer, that is WBC. Then it is nothing but the blood test. So blood test, it is used for leukemia. Then PSA, that is PSA test. What is PSA? Prostate specific antigen test. And this test, it is used for identification of prostate cancer, prostate gland. It is present in male reproductive system. So if there is occurrence of that cancer, then prostate specific antigens test, it is used for identification of the prostate cancer. Mammogram, detection and diagnosis of mammary cancer. So mammogram means what is exactly? Mammogram, it is nothing but use of x-ray to identify the cancerous tissue in the mammary glands. So here what we are doing, we are using low energy x-rays for examination of the beast. So if there is a presence of the cancerous cell, it can be easily detected with the help of this mammogram. And then another x-ray, CT scan and MRI. So x-ray machines are there. CT scan, that is computed tomography. It is called as computer tomography. That means here also there is a presence of x-rays. So here x-ray machine separately used for identification and detection of the cancer, or that x-ray, they are used in CT scans. Then it is also detecting the cancerous cell. Or we are using the MRI, magnetic resonance imaging technique. CT scan and MRI, they are used for identification of cancerous cells which are present inside our body. If you want to go for identification of liver cancer, or if we take the example of rectum cancer, intestinal cancers, pancreatic cancers, like this, whatever organs which are present, brain tumors, so different types of the cancer detection, small or very few cancerous cells are there in our body. Early diagnosis, early detection, we can go for MRI and CT scan. So these are responsible for detecting and diagnosis of the internal structural cancers. And last one, it is nothing but use of monoclonal antibodies for detection and diagnosis of the cancer. Single type of the antibodies. Take the example, lung cancer is there. So lung cancer, so this is the cancerous cell. On this cell there is a presence of particular type of the antigen. Cancerous cell, on that there is a presence of antigen. Now this antigen, it will make attachment with this type of the antibody. Single type of monoclonal, only one type of antibodies. Only one type of antibodies they are added, so that when it makes attachment with the antigen, what it gives? It gives the confirmation that there is a presence of cancerous cells. So identification of the cancerous cell by using monoclonal antibodies, it is called as monoclonal antibody test. It is called as monoclonal antibody cell test. So these are the number of detection and diagnosis of cancer. Okay, biopsy, blood test, prostate specific antigen test, mammogram, X-ray, CT scan, MRI, monoclonal antibody test, all these are there. Now we will go for treatment of cancer. Once disease occurred, when once cancer occurs, early diagnosis occur. If there is occurrence of early diagnosis and detection, then there is a possibility of then confirmed treatment will occur. Confirmed treatment. But when the cancer is present in late stage, treatment is not possible. It leads to death of the individual. Okay. So early detection and diagnosis, treatment is possible. Late detection and diagnosis, treatment is not possible. If early treatment occurs, early diagnosis occurs, now what are the methods which are used for treatment? First one, it is nothing but surgical removal. Surgical removal. What is this surgical removal? Wherever there is a presence of tumor, cut and remove that tumor. Cut and remove that tumor. So this is the best method. But one of the demerit of this surgical treatment removal, it is nothing but just consider this is the tumor. When we are cutting and removing this, one cell, if it remains in the body, we have cut and removed this tumor. Suppose only one cell, if it remains in that region, again it develops the cancer. Again it develops the cancer. So surgical removal of the tumor, it is so easy. Cut and remove the tumor part. But suppose single cell remained there, again it leads to causation of tumor or cancer. Okay, so surgical removal. Second one, radiation therapy. Radiation therapy, that means use of radiations for treatment of cancer. X-rays, gamma rays, alpha rays, beta rays, whatever the radiations are there, these radiations, they are penetrated on or they are focused on cancer or the tumors. When these radiations, when they are focused on the cancer, so these radiations, they are responsible for killing the cancerous cell. They are killing the cancerous cell. So this is called as radiation therapy. But problem is, again, suppose here this much region, it is nothing but the cancerous region. And suppose here there is a presence of normal cell. Though these radiations, by killing the cancerous cell, if they are acting on normal cell, again this normal cell, it will become cancerous. So again the demerit is there. Radiation therapy, it is used for treatment of cancer, but suppose these radiations, they are affecting the normal cell, again that normal cell may become cancerous. Okay, so surgical removal, radiation therapy. Next one, it is nothing but chemotherapy. Use of chemicals to treat the cancer. Use of chemicals to treat the cancer. If we take the example, Taxol. If we take the example, Taxol. It is the chemical used for treatment of number of cancers. When we are using chemical therapy, when we are using chemotherapy, demerit of this chemotherapy is, first, merit of this chemotherapy is it is responsible for curing the cancer. But demerit of chemotherapy is it is responsible for giving rise to other type of the symptoms. It is giving rise to other type of the symptoms such as alopecia and anemia. Alopecia and anemia. That means when we are going for chemotherapy, chemicals, they will destroy all the cancerous cells present in our body. But as they are destroying, they are affecting our body. How they are affecting? First, the symptom which we are getting, it is nothing but alopecia. Alopecia means what? It is nothing but loss of hairs. It is nothing but loss of hairs. What will happen when we are using this chemical? Hair follicles are there. These hair follicles, they are totally damaged. That's why on our body, whatever the hairs are there, total loss of hairs, it is occurring due to chemotherapy. And second one, it is nothing but anemia. Anemia, it is nothing but blood count or the RBC count, it decreases. Okay, so this is occurring because these chemicals, they affect the bone marrow function. They affect the bone marrow function. That's why there is occurrence of these symptoms. But chemotherapy nowadays, it is the therapy used throughout the world for treatment of cancer, because this is the best method for treatment of the cancer. And last one, it is nothing but immunotherapy. Immunotherapy means immunological cells, T cells or B cells or antibodies. All these are nothing but the immune cells. So immune cells, they are used for killing the cancerous cells. But speciality of cancerous cell, these cancerous cells, they are not detected. Sometimes these are not detected by our immune cells. When cancerous cells, they are not detected by our immune cells, for that purpose we are using biological response modifier. We are using biological response modifier, that is alpha interferon. And these alpha interferons, they will go and bind to the cancer cell, and our immune cells, they start killing the cancer cell. So here, alpha interferons, these are the biological response modifiers, and these modifiers, they go and identify the cancer cell. Our immune cells, they go and attack those, and they will kill the cancer cell. So surgical removal, radiation therapy, chemotherapy, immunotherapy, these are the methods of treatment of cancer. So this is the end of cancer.